Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Joyce and this is Joyce Kainas Canada channel on YouTube. Guys, thank you so much for coming. Thank you for those of you who have subscribed. Thank you for those who have been sending me comments. I've been reading them and I appreciate you so much. Thank you to the new, to our new guests, our new visitors who are coming to subscribe on our channel. We appreciate you. You're welcome. Just to let you know, just to update a little bit, for the sake of the newcomers, on this channel, we share about Canada immigration. So we give people tips on how to immigrate to Canada. And the information that I give is not in any way legal advice. In case you need a lawyer, we have got one who is Helen, and I'm going to share her contacts here on the video, after the video in the description, so that you can contact her in case you need any help. Only that she doesn't get people jobs, but she can do the application processes for you, and she can also assess you and advise you which process is good for you. So lately, we have been discussing on how you can immigrate to Canada under RULO and Northern Immigration Pilot. And we said that we have got 11 communities, RULO communities, which are participating in this RULO and Northern Immigration Pilot. And we are doing our last RULO community. Guys, that shows a great achievement. I hope you're applying for these jobs, and I would like to hear from you what is the outcome. I know several people who have done interviews. We are waiting to hear from the employers. So continue doing the applications. I have just done a resume video on how to make a CV. I'm going to upload it. It's uploading right now. So I'm going to edit and post it. Maybe in the next 2-3 hours, I'll post it. Make sure that you watch that video for how to make a resume to suit this Canadian job post. So today we are going to talk about, these are the 11 communities. There are 5 communities in Ontario. Then there are 2 in Manitoba, there are 1 in Saskatchewan, there's 1 in Saskatchewan, there's 2 in Alberta, and lastly, we have got West Kootenay is in British Columbia. So West Kootenay is our last rural community in British Columbia, and their website looks like this. Looks a green community, not so bad. As I can see here from this picture, it looks good. So I want us to go through briefly and see what they require you. So in the information for applicants, this is always our interest. We are going to click here and see what they need. Here they are cooking. As you can see here on this picture, they're in the kitchen. It looks like they have got so many jobs for the chef, for the bakers and all that. So applicants here, employers, employment, community criteria, it's all here. So the process, in case you need to contact them, they have their email address here. The process is that you need to ensure that you meet federal eligibility requirements. That one is just like any other rural community. Secondly, they are saying here that you need to find full-time employment in the community. And then after that, you ensure that you and your employer meet the community-based criteria. The community-based criteria and the federal eligibility requirements are almost the same. Remember, the federal is the entire government, the entire Canada government requirements. There are 6 of them. In case you want to understand how to meet federal eligibility requirements, you can click this link because I'm going to share it on the description. And you can also watch my video on express entry. If you watch my video, and it's also on the description on this video as a summary, if you watch my video for express entry, you will understand what is federal eligibility and how you can qualify through points. Then community eligibility is almost the same, only that some communities require you maybe to stay there for 1 year or 2 years before you can move to another community, to another place after they nominate you. Guys, remember the importance of finding these jobs. The reason why we are applying for jobs in the rural communities and in the provinces is because we want to boost our federal eligibility requirements. Because we do not have enough points, because most of the time they want 430 points and above, sometimes 420. Because we do not have those points, that's why we are applying for jobs, so that we can boost our express entry profile. Otherwise, if you have got 430 points and above, you do not need to do all this. You just go ahead and apply. You don't need a job offer. If you have got 450 points, just go ahead and apply under express entry. And for you to know whether you qualify to apply, you need to watch my video for CRS Core. CRS Core. All these videos that I'm telling you, I have shared them on the description and on the first pinned comment of this video. So that in case you want to understand what you are talking about, watch those videos, understand. In case you have any questions, attend my live sessions. I come to talk to people for free consultations. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, I bring Helen. So you have got 3 days in a week to, after you have read these things and you don't understand anything, you can come on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 8 p.m. East Africa time or Kenya time. I come to discuss any questions that you have. I address and I give you questions, answers for free. So ensure that you and your employer meet the community-based criteria. Then how to apply West Kutune application is right here, and then you go ahead and apply. Please note that applications will not be considered if they are incomplete and they do not meet minimum qualifications. The first minimum qualification is that you need a job offer from a West Kutune employer. The advantage of these jobs is that they don't need you to have an LMIA. You can apply without an LMIA. Then you need English and possibly French language credentials. For this one, for West Kutune, do not apply if you have not done IELTS. Just leave it alone. And then education credential requirements, ECA report. Some communities do not need you to have ECA. Some communities do not need you to have English IELTS. Some provinces like New Brunswick, initially they do not require you to have them. But finally, you will need them. Because there is no way you're going to do your express entry. Finally, you're not going to get your permanent resident without English and without ECA report. You will finally need those documents. So start preparing how to pass your English test. In case you need to prepare for your English test and pass, I have done a video and it's also on the description of this video. I have done a summary of all the important videos and I have shared the links on this video on the description. Click all those links on the description or the first pinned comment, because some people don't know how to go to the description. I never knew also, I'm learning these things. The first pinned comment, I'm always pinning it, it's mine. You can read through and learn and understand. In case you do not understand anything, please attend my live sessions on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday on Joyce K Content channel. Joyce K Content. It's not on this channel. I don't come live on this channel. It's on Joyce K Content channel. And that channel is specifically just for live sessions. I don't do anything else. I just come live Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So guys, I'm going to share with you the link for this West Kutune community. Then you go ahead and apply. Let me see here what they're saying. Find full-time employment. Or we wanted to see whether they have got jobs in the rural communities, because some, like Sudbury, we realize Sudbury and which other community, guys, who can remember? I remember Sudbury does not have a job bank. So the communities that do not have a job bank, they have told you to go and check the job bank for the federal government, because the entire government of Canada has got a job bank that has got those job posts. So if a community does not give you jobs, then they always share with you a job bank link. For the federal government. And when you click that link, it takes you to the job bank. It is stated there, that community jobs straight there. So here they have introduced you to Indeed. I always don't like Indeed, but whenever a community shares Indeed, when you click Indeed, it will lead you to jobs that are from the community. So you not get stranded. It is still okay to apply under Indeed. If a link for Indeed is coming from the community, that's what I always say. If Indeed has been shared by the community and you follow it, that job cannot be from a scammer. It can never be from a scammer because you have followed it from the community. It's the community that has posted those jobs. But sometimes when you look, you find a job outside the community, you can always find a scammer. But when it's a link that has been shared by the community or the province, like here, you can rarely find a scammer. But also, West Kutuni has got jobs here. Let's see the jobs they have briefly. Kutuni Career Development Society. Okay. This one, they're saying that if you're not currently in Canada, there are some links here that are going to help you for job seekers to apply to work in Canada, extend your work permit. Oh, okay. For Kutune, they're saying that as a job seeker from outside Canada, you are eligible for employment if you are a Canadian citizen, you are a permanent resident of Canada, you hold a temporary work permit for working in Canada. So West Kutune, they're straightforward. If you are outside Canada, you may not find jobs for that community, unlike other communities. For this community, unfortunately, it's like they don't want people who are, I don't know, for job seekers. Maybe you can click all these links that I'm going to share with you, but here it's like they want people who are already here. In case you're coming to Canada as a visitor, this is what you can do. You can come here as a visitor, apply for jobs. Once you get a work permit, once you get a job, not a work permit, once you get a job, you can always apply for work permit. And maybe you can apply to the rural communities. So, guys, that's all about this Kutune community. I think it was the last, and I don't like it so much. But you can still apply. And then next, in the next 2-3 hours, I'll be posting a link or a video for making a Canadian CV or a Canadian resume. Make sure that you check it out. Thank you, guys. God bless you. Remember to like this video, like, put a thumbs up, and also share this information. Thank you. God bless you. Bye-bye.